They're a familiar sight. Railroad cars, tanker trucks, and storage tanks. They carry contents under great pressure, and they bear warnings with good reason. This type of explosion is called a BLEVE, an acronym for Boiling Liquid Expanding Vapor Explosion. When they happen, they're devastating and often deadly. And these are some of the worst in history. September 3rd, 1983, Murdoch, Illinois. A freight train hauling 30,000 gallons of liquid petroleum gas derails and catches fire. As the heat intensifies, pressure builds inside the tankers until... The BLEVE is so powerful, it hurls this huge tanker as if it were a toy. Burning into the night, the fire spreads. Another tanker car is engulfed and explodes. Amazingly, no one is killed. July 25th, 2007. Dallas, Texas. A case of multiple BLEVEs. At a Dallas welding supply company, more than 100 canisters of acetylene gas explode. The blast rocked downtown Dallas for more than a half hour. But what caused this horrifying BLEVE? It begins with a routine fuel delivery. Something goes wrong, and the highly flammable acetylene gas leaks from the hose.
Once the leak mixed with air, it either was ignited by static electricity or some type of open flame within the general area.
The truck erupts in flames and explodes. The fire quickly spreads to an adjacent building that stores acetylene and propane gas in individual canisters.
The initial explosion caused the flame impingement on the small canisters that are being stored within the area, and these little canisters are starting to go off like bombs.
One after another, the canisters explode, sending huge pieces of shrapnel flying. Each one a deadly projectile.
Here we have a piece of shrapnel that actually was shot approximately about a half a block from the initial incident, and it's still on fire.
The explosions shoot plumes of smoke hundreds of feet into the air. Two employees are seriously burned, and the disaster causes $2.3 million worth of damage. Fortunately, in this instance too, no one is killed. But what caused the accident in the first place? How does a simple gas leak cause so much devastation? The answer lies in the unique nature of a BLEVE.
What we have is a small compressed gas cylinder that is filled with a flammable gas up to a certain level.
Fire in the hole!
As an external heat source is applied, the gas expands within the canister and the pressure increases, pushing against the inside of the container wall. When the pressure exceeds the strength of the canister, it explodes.
The fireball that accompanies the explosion is from the fuel vapor mixture igniting.
This same dangerous process can happen with any compressed gas, but on a larger scale, the results can be deadly. October 6th, 2007, Tacoma, Washington. One of the largest BLEVEs in American history occurs at the Atlas Foundry. Atlas produces metal castings for logging, shipping, and other major industries. The deadly chain of events begins when a tanker truck arrives to deliver 8,000 gallons of liquefied propane to the foundry. As the propane is being transferred to one of the foundry's storage tanks, a mechanical failure occurs in the supply line. Propane vapors escape from the truck. The vapors are heavier than air, so they hug the ground as they spread out, blanketing the area. Then, something, possibly just a random spark, ignites the gas, and the propane truck explodes. Ian Swenson and his father, Greg, are just four blocks away at the time of the blast.
We saw the smoke coming up, and so we wandered down this way more to get a better look at it, and I grabbed my camera to get some pictures.
Within minutes of the initial explosion, first responders from the Tacoma Fire Department arrive on the scene.
We saw flames over the building the whole time. Weren't very alarmed at that point. We heard something about a propane tank. See a lot of propane tanks and fires.
But as they get closer, it becomes clear that this is no ordinary fire.
It's a loud roar, like you were 10 or 20 feet from a jet engine. Me and my two coworkers at the time on engine number two knew that something really bad was going to happen.
It was how I would have pictured a nuclear explosion.
The fireball kept expanding, and it didn't look like it was ever going to stop.
The heat was intense. I thought it had singed my eyebrows off, and I was amazed that it could be that hot over that, you know, it's almost three, four blocks away.
The blast sets off a fire that burns for hours, long into the night, and it knocks out a nearby electrical plant, cutting power to 30,000 people.
The truck driver for the propane truck, he was airlifted to the hospital up in Seattle. He suffered serious burns as a result of the explosion.
Several days later comes unfortunate news. The driver dies. The explosion rocks the entire area.
When you had the axle from the truck land up on the overpass for Highway 16, and if it's throwing something, you know, had to be 1,000 pounds, 500 feet in the air, the force is just hard to comprehend.
In addition, three Atlas employees are seriously injured, all the result of a blevy that was felt for miles.